Be of good cheer, my little ones, for I, Yahushua Mashiach, am the only good shepherd, and I am exposing the evangelical prosperity pimps for the wolves they are. I am beating the wolves away and removing their fangs from your flesh. Oh, my beloved little ones, I speak to those who worship, love, strive to obey and live holy to Abba Yahweh. How you please, I, your Yahushua HaMashiach. I am the only good shepherd and the only redeemer of your soul. My sheep and lambs know my voice, and like a deer pants for water in the heat of the day, so too my sheep pants for my next word.
They know the taste of the living water as they read my holy scriptures. They drink of my living water daily.
True prophecies are living water also. Each time you read one, you will get another revelation if you study and ask me what you do not understand. You who desire to have a heart after my own heart, you please, Abba Yahweh. I have put a boldness in you where others have refused to use this gift of boldness for my glory or use it for evil purposes for their own motivations. Do not follow Oprah Winfrey. Do not support her or encourage her by watching her programs or buying her books she promotes. Oprah Winfrey will send you to hell if you believe Oprah's gospel. She rebukes children of mine before the world who were sent to warn her that there is only one way to heaven, and that is through the shed blood of Yahushua HaMashiach. The woman I used to do battle with her called me by the Greek name Jesus Christ. When they confronted her on her television program, Oprah battled with them before millions and rebuked them angrily and said she refused to believe there is only one way to heaven. She believes there are multiple paths to heaven. One way cannot be right. Beware of Oprah Winfrey. As I prophesied through Elisabeth Elijah years ago, she has sold her soul to Satan for fame and fortune, and now does her good works, saying good works is one of her ways to heaven. She's become a Judas, and where once she taught the truth, she has now forsaken it and chosen a path that leads to hell. You have been warned, and I will hold you, holy children, accountable for supporting and encouraging her in any way. Oprah Winfrey will lead souls to the Antichrist, the one I call the only begotten son of Satan, who come before in the form of Judas. There is a woman who is called Cherie Schreiner. She's an author of books and claims she can decipher Bible codes. She twists the Bible codes and conform them into the image she chooses. She says her name Cherie in numerology means Yahweh, and Schreiner means time. Well, now it is time for Yahweh to expose her in his timing. Cherie Schreiner mixes truth with lies. Cherie Schreiner is the reptilian alien that she warns about when she wrote and now sells her book, Aliens on the Internet. She only posts a picture of herself, of what she looked like in school years ago. Where is her picture for today? She fears others will see what I, Yahweh, am revealing now. She works for both sides of the gods, one from earth and one from hell. Cherie Schreiner mocks Apostle Paul and says any book in the Bible he wrote, throw it out. She twists scriptures to try and prove Paul was not one of my apostles. So therefore she is of serpent seed. Cherie Schreiner has sold her soul to Satan and allowed her body to be taken over by alien powers for fame and fortune. She mocks this ministry and warned Elisabeth when Elisabeth told her that Elisabeth's middle name is Cherie, and Elisabeth was going by the name Cherie when she was used to birth a mighty wind ministry. Upon hearing this, Cherie Schreiner told Elisabeth years ago over the phone There is room only for one Cherie here, and that is Cherie Schreiner. You stay, Elisabeth. Cherie Schreiner also did Elisabeth's name in Bible code, which she normally charges $100. She let Elisabeth know she spent days doing her Bible code for free and let her know that both of them are generals and leaders. However, she let Elisabeth know there were the words gibberish tongues in Elisabeth's Bible code. Elisabeth rebuked her and reminded her of what is written in the book of Acts, that speaking in holy unknown tongues is speaking in tongues of men and angels. Cherie Schreiner argued back and said, Paul taught that and you have to throw it out. Cherie Schreiner mocks speaking in holy tongues. She mocks because Satan at one time, by her own testimony, gave her demonic tongues. This is because Cherie Schreiner had head knowledge and no heart knowledge of the one she called Jesus Christ at that time. Now, to confuse people, she calls what the book of Acts calls speaking in an unknown tongue the words of the devil. Cherie Schreiner is a false prophet. Time and again this has been proven, and she has given Bible codes with dates and nothing comes to pass. Beware. Cherie Schreiner does have some knowledge Satan gave to her in exchange for her soul that she was never to know. Do not go to her website unless you have I, Yahweh's permission. For there are tracking devices for both of the leaders she works for. If you are looking for her to protect you in any way, beware, for your names are already on a list of hers. If you have purchased the emergency rations she sells, your name is on a list she has compiled. If you are on her email list, beware, you are also on the government's email list, as well as Satan's. Cherie Schreiner sells her orgone and claims her orgone will keep demons, aliens, sickness, disease, poverty, and weather disasters away from you. I, Yahweh, now decree, Cherie Schreiner, you have been warned. How dare you say something you make with your own hands can defeat the demons, or cure anyone, or control the weather. Cherie Schreiner, you are a false prophet to the highest degree. You slander Elisabeth Cherie Elijah because you know both of you are called to be leaders. She is a leader of I, Yahweh, YAHUSHUA, and our beloved precious Ruach HaKodesh, also called Mama Wisdom. Cherie Schreiner, you have sold your soul to Satan. You are one of Satan's leaders. This is true. You have head knowledge. This is true. But that is all you have. You even copy the Hebrew ways of this messianic ministry to confuse the people. Before, your only target was the Christians in the name of Jesus. Now you target the Jews in YAHUSHUA's name. Cherie Schreiner, you are not even who people think you are. You are a worker of iniquity, and I warn you, let this broadcast far and wide warn everyone. Cherie Schreiner promotes her orgone for the destruction of minds, bodies, spirits, and souls. Do not put your faith in orgone. Put your faith in I, Yahweh, and YAHUSHUA to protect you in the days of calamity. She says she knows you can pray to YAHUSHUA for protection, but that is the hard way. Instead, she says, buy her orgone, and it is the easy way. Blasphemy! Nothing can protect you but the name and the shed blood of YAHUSHUA HaMashiach. Cherie Schreiner, I, Yahweh, rebuke you now for saying your orgone will protect people from demons and UFOs full of demonic aliens. My little ones, do not discard this warning about the UFOs and aliens. But realize only I, YAHUVEH, and YAHUSHUA HaMashiach can and will protect you in the days of calamity and tribulation. This is the truth about the Oregon. She makes and sells and tells you to plant all over various parts of the world, or tells you to wear it on a neck chain, or put it in your bedrooms or inside your home. Here is a truth I, YAHUVEH, speak forth from Elisabeth Cherie Elijah. It is Elisabeth that has a holy warrior spirit, as David had as a shepherd boy when he battled Goliath. Cherie Shriner is not the granddaughter of King David of old, as she claims. In fact, Cherie Shriner is a Goliath of evil, speaking forth doctrines of devils and secrets revealed to her by Satan, and mixing in some biblical truth to confuse the people. Cherie Shriner is the alien on the internet, and she is not what she portrays herself to be. You have been warned. I send you forth, Elisabeth Cherie Elijah, to do what you have asked me not to do, and that is to expose, battle, and speak forth words to this alien on the internet named Cherie Shriner in the name of YAHUVEH. Cherie Shriner, you target the Christians and Messianic Jews because they are the ones Satan wants to destroy the most. Beware, holy people, and warn others. The Orgon she makes, she claims, is her secret recipe, and that it works different than other Orgon. But in truth, it will attract the demons. Your homes will become possessed with evil spirits. The land you planned or Orgon will be as a tracking device to the devil and the aliens who are already here in disguise. They are Satan's fallen elite troops. Because you put your faith in her Orgon, I, YAHUVEH, will allow sickness to come upon your body. I, YAHUVEH, will allow your homes to become infested with evil. I, YAHUVEH, will allow poverty where you had prosperity. I will allow the destroyer to destroy all you own if you do not repent, dig up, warn, and demand your money back. Spend on her books, emergency supplies, and her Orgon, and redeem the finances I give you into holy ground. I, YAHUVEH, have warned you. If you depend on her Orgon to protect you, you have been sorely deceived. This image of a woman laughs all the way to the bank because you believed her lies. For those who continue to believe her lies, death and destruction is all you will see. Why do you think she brags her Orgon is better than anyone else's? Because she has a secret recipe? Her Orgon will not save anyone and will harm everyone who does not repent and ask me for forgiveness for the stupidity of believing the lies sent by Satan. She exposes the enemies of YAHUSHUA for one purpose, and that is to gain your trust. Why do you think she calls Ben Hinn evil names and tells you when he ministers, go and plant her Orgon where he is ministering around the world? I will tell you why. It is because this empowers his strange occult fire. How else can Satan get you to take part in planting her Orgon if you do not think you are fighting evil? Why do you think she now begs for money to build her Orgon factories around the world? Yes, even internationally, she wants to contaminate the atmosphere because this benefits Satan's elite forces that are coming from space. They are the princes and powers of the air, and some are already here. They need her Orgon. This Orgon is also affecting global warming, so be warned. YAHUSHUA's demon stompers, arise now and cover this ministry and support it in a way you have never done thus far. Write and encourage them and set a time to pray. Let Elisabeth and Nico know they are not alone as they take on these battles in my name. Encourage them and set a time on the clock to commit to prayer for them and all the partners in this ministry. I have asked this ministry to take on attacks from humans and demons, and yet now they are asked to fight in a battle that comes from outer space and the realm of hell itself. Elisabeth has delayed this word going forth because every time she would read the prophecies concerning this, she would be fought in the supernatural realm and dreams of aliens would attack her. Yet someone must warn my holy children that are caught up with the spirit of mind control and mind manipulation. Even a visit to Cherie Shriner's site without our YAHUVEH's permission is dangerous. Do not go to her site. Do not even look up her name unless you know you are prayed up and the devil is bound along with the demons and you are strong spiritually and you have my permission. Pray against this evil Cherie Shriner and what she's doing and what she has done. If you discern, you are also to take an active role in rebuking the lies coming from the mouth of this reptilian alien who is also part of Satan's alien elite troop. Do it now! She names others who are in high profile and governmental positions and calls them reptilian. Who better to know another reptilian than one that is of the same alien elite troop? Beloved children, I tell you this so you will not fear when you see things come to pass. You thought was only a figment of another's imagination. Even the horror movies you watch depict actual monstrous creatures in hell which will walk this earth during the Great Tribulation. Do not be deceived. There are satanic plants sent from witches and Satanists' covens, attending and even ministering in churches and messianic temples. They are in the majority of what is called Christian chat rooms and internet Christian forums. And in them, Satan has his satanic plants placed as vocal speakers, and their job is to chase away anyone who is truly holy and speaking forth YAHUVEH and I, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, and are filled with our beloved precious Ruach HaKodesh. Say not that you have not been warned by this prophet I speak through now. There are evangelists and pastors in what you call mega churches, consisting of thousands of members. You will know the evangelists and pastors, both men and women, who compromise my holy truths and steal my glory. You will know the evangelical prosperity pimps who live in mansions and are millionaires and look down upon the poor and middle class. Yet it is the poor and middle class that have made the evangelical prosperity pimps the millionaires they are today. You can call them the EPPs, for they will be used as your enemies to introduce and lead people to the false Christ, the only begotten son of Satan. Woe be unto those reading this that give finances to the mega churches. I, YAHUSHUA, will hold you accountable where you sow your seed, whether it be in fertile ground with uncompromised truth, where you are nourished, or if it be in barren ground with man-made doctrines, where only the pastors get fat of your tithes and offerings. John Hagee, you are a Judas, a wolf in sheep's clothing, preaching out of both sides of your mouth. You lie to the Jewish people and say, YAHUSHUA did not come to earth to be Israel's Messiah. You tell them YAHUSHUA understands why you do not receive him as Messiah. You set them up to receive the Antichrist as Messiah and have sold them out for silver and gold. For the sake of feeding your greed for fame and fortune, you feed the sheep and lambs some truth mixed with abominational lies. John Hagee, I have released another prophetic message through this prophet, and you are doomed. And all those who are in your congregation had better flee while there is yet time. The Evangelical Prosperity Pimps invited the demons of greed and pride, and the demon invited the demon of Judas. Those I have named and those I will name have compromised my truth. Instead of lifting up my name, they have lifted up their names, putting it on buildings, ministries, and churches. The evangelical pimps now love gold and silver more than they love my sheep and lambs. And if they do not repent and turn away from this wicked road they are on, most of those I name in this word will never see heaven. Some had their names in the book of life, and their names was blotted out. As they betrayed me in heaven, so they betrayed me again on earth. For their soul already knows where it will go when it leaves this earth. Now they have a form of godliness, but no godliness within. Jude Thomas, repent now publicly. The words you have written in a book describing your so-called trip to heaven is a trick from Satan. Beloved children, just because someone says they have been to heaven, test with my words and see if it lines up with my description of heaven. Every pastor that has promoted and promotes the lies that True Thomas has written, you also are fit for my fury if you do not openly repent and rebuke these lies. You have helped lead my sheep and lambs astray. How could you not recognize these lies she has written in her book? Any true prophet would rebuke and warn. You know who the true prophets are, because like the one I'm speaking through now, they are loudly crying out Jude Thomas is a false prophet who claims she walked and talked with J-E-S-U-S. She claims she had an out-of-body experience and Jesus took her to heaven 17 times in 1 month, and each time it was preceded by violent manifestations at an appointed time. Why would I do such a thing as this? Am I not a loving shepherd? It is Satan that shakes her body, not I. It is Satan that violently abuses her in what she calls an anointing on her hands and arms and makes her feel as though her hands are breaking apart. It is Satan who mocks her. It is Satan that rewards her. As this illusion is believed by my holy people, she says that whenever Jesus took her to heaven, all she did was cry because it was so sad there. But I, YAHUSHUA, say, heaven is a place where there is only joy. For is it not written that I will wipe away every tear from your eyes? My beloved, no words can ever describe the beauty of heaven. All who believe these lies must repent for believing that I, the Good Shepherd, would treat my sheep and lambs like this. All those who believe this must repent for not asking for discernment whether this be truth or lies. Jude Thomas's book is full of false doctrine. Study and show yourself approved and burn her book, letting Satan know you no longer receive his lies. In these end times, why would I not tell anyone that has been in heaven my true Hebrew name? Why would I encourage you to attend a Sunday church, knowing what the Sunday church will be used for in the Great Tribulation? Why would you not return from heaven with a warning to the pastors to change their day of worship to the true Shabbat? Where did I ever mention there was a purgatory outside the gates of heaven? In Jude Thomas's words, there are two valleys outside the gates of the kingdom. This is nonsense. Evangelists and pastors are supposed to feed my truths and to lead by example. These evil ones have compromised, twisted my words, and conform into their own self-made comfortable image that strive to offend no one. All of these named have proven by their works and thoughts they have lost their fear for Yahweh. They will all quote the scriptures, but all of them have gone astray. Creflo Dollar, I have this against you. You worship the Almighty Dollar. Paul and Dan Crouch, Joel Osteen, Marilyn Hickey, Joyce Meyer, Creflo Dollar, Benny Hinn, Kenneth Copeland, Steve Munsey, Rick Joyner, Pat Robertson, Earl Roberts, Richard and Lindsey Roberts, Juanita Bynum, and Thomas Weeks, Paula White, Rodney Howard-Browne, Mike Murdock, Carman, Billy Graham, Teddy Jakes, Rod Parsley, and Kim Clement. These are just a few examples of evangelical prosperity pimps, and they are pimps for the devil, as they have forsaken their original calling and humble beginnings. Evangelical prosperity pimps have named the ministries and churches after themselves. Joel Osteen, you are lukewarm, and I, Yahweh, vomit you out of my mouth.
You preach psychological babble that cannot save anyone's soul.
I, YAHUSHUA, have this against you, Joel Osteen. You preach the devil's doctrine of the Antichrist, a new age feel-good religion that leads everyone who believes you to hell. Joel Osteen, where will you hide when it feels like the Astrodome crashes in on you?
You fool yourself, Joel Osteen. You chase away the holy who warn you to repent of your sins and warn you about hell. Just because you deny there is a hell does not mean you will not spend eternity there and with your wife and children and all your congregation that believe your lies if you do not repent. Just because you refuse to warn about the devil does not mean Satan is not the ruler of your heart and soul. You are exposed, and the people reading this will warn others and send this prophecy to all those mentioned in this prophetic word. Holy people, flee from these evangelical pimps of prosperity. They deceive people, quoting scriptures as if they live them, and yet they do not. Beware of the wolves disguised as leaders, where people gather and discuss my coming again. One in particular hates this ministry, plots the rapture date, as if I am listening to them. They dare to call themselves Rapture Now, and the leaders have not my Holy Spirit within them. They lie to themselves and others, yet I am not deceived. I send my holy sheep again and again into the den of wolves, where innocent lambs lay amongst the wolves who rule these evil internet forms. John McArthur, you are the head wolf of the Rapture Now, and I, the good shepherd, know how to beat off the wolves and remove the fangs from my sheep. Who are you to label Elisabeth Elijah a false prophet? Are you not the same one who insists you would be taken to heaven in 4 weeks? And that was September 14, 2007. Did you not speak it aloud and clear over the internet and to all who would listen? Did you not say that Jesus said 9 times to you, you will be in heaven in 4 weeks?
Well, since I, YAHUSHUA, cannot lie, and you are still alive and on earth, and it is past September 14th, can you not admit that you do not know my voice?
How then can you judge others and brand them false prophets? How can you say before a multitude of people, stay away from amightywind.com? It is the work of Satan.
How can you believe Jack Barr, who is only fit for Yahweh's destruction? He is not a pastor or a prophet.
only another evil mouth spewing forth his venom on the internet directed at the true holy prophets. He is another one who has the spirit of religion, doomed to hell and the lake of fire. Satan especially loves to claim a person's soul who professes to be a Christian, and yet by their fruits you know them. Jack Barr prefers to believe gossip sent from a servant of Satan to accuse Elisabeth unjustly. Jack Barr was sent from Satan to slander Elisabeth Elijah with the spirit of destruction, to try to destroy a work that does nothing but glorify Abba Yahweh, our Yahushua, and our beloved precious Ruach HaKodesh. This ministry reaches souls for me all over the world. This ministry sacrifices for my sake to feed the lambs and sheep my truths, and to be my prophetic mouthpiece to the nations and proclaim my blessings or curses on each land I send them to. I speak to the one that calls himself John McGarvey and others on the Rapture Now forum who refuse to even give your true full names. You call yourself Christian moderators on this internet forum and brag how you chase away people who come to you speaking forth my words. None of you even know the meaning of the word love. And what God do you pray to? For I am not listening to you until you repent and start obeying the words I, Yahushua, speak forth. I speak now to the Rapture Now forum and use as an example. But the internet is full of so-called Christian forums with the same spirit of Jezebel. You who slander and mock this ministry and call Elisabeth Elijah a false prophet, beware, for none of you took this to prayer. None of you tasted and tested the good fruit of this ministry, for all of you have motivations to destroy the truths spoken through my prophet. Jezebel tries to kill all my prophets and failed and will always fail. Just as Elijah of old, I made a way of escape, so too I protect my Elijah of new. Enemies of this ministry who seek its destruction, you know you cannot do it any other way than to slander it and speak lies about Elisabeth, the one I used to birth this ministry. Do not think I am amused, for I know the number of hairs on your heads, and I am going to use the Rapture Now forum as an example of what the Good Shepherd does to wolves that say they are godly and yet have no godliness within them. They quote my words, attack my true prophets and chase them away, and yet applaud the false prophets sitting in the den of wolves, for they themselves are false prophets. None truly know me, and this ministry has been set up to be a refiner of metals, as in Jeremiah 6:27-30. People don't like that they do not measure up to what Abba Yahweh expects in his holy children, so they try to stone this messenger. Yet those whose names are in the Lamb's Book of Life know the voice of the Good Shepherd, and they recognize the truths found in this ministry. There are some right now that have slandered this ministry and prophet, and yet have felt the holy fire of my conviction burning in their bones. Repent now, privately to Yahushua and publicly to Elisabeth. Others have felt the fear of Yahweh, knowing they have sinned against this prophet. Repent now before it is too late. Still others know they were to write and speak forth and defend her and this ministry, but were more afraid of what the bullies in the Rapture Now and Five Doves Forum would do to them. They feared Jim Bramlett and what he would say. They feared being banned from the forum instead of what I, Yahushua Mashiach, and Abba Yahweh would do to them. The beginning of wisdom is the fear of Yahweh. Have you not read this in scripture? I caution you, test the spirit that speaks, and realize the leader of the Rapture Now forum is a false prophet. By his own words, he has hung himself and been exposed. The governments and many nations are sitting in these forums, watching and waiting, as they have spies there, taking names and disguised as sheep or prophets for the evil future days ahead. Use wisdom now and discern what I am writing about. Satan has his moderators there, taking names and taking notes on all of your weaknesses. Use wisdom and discern what I am warning about. Beware of people who make excuses for false prophets. A false prophet is a man or a woman that gives a date, and that doth say if the Lord is spoken, and that date passes, and what they prophesy does not come to pass. Some prophets who have done this unknowingly must repent publicly and apologize, since they spoke the words to the masses through books, letters, the internet, or spoken word. They can be forgiven if they did not prophesy falsely for their own motivations. People, you are not helping them repent if you are making excuses for them. You will also be held accountable for doing this.
People, you must discern whether it is prayer that delayed the prophetic message or whether it was a prophecy of the flesh.
Prayer will delay my judgment for a short time, but woe be unto the people when the delay has ended. It will be greater devastation than that which was prophesied. Shelby Corbett, though your intentions were originally good, you were deceived by others, and the lying, deceiving spirit you received from Kenneth Copeland and Chew Thomas, and among others you listened to. I have warned through Elisabeth Elijah that a false rapture is being planned even now, where people will be taken away or vaporized by governmental weapons in disguise. Satan's elite force will come in the form of UFOs and USOs and remove people in a way you think is only science fiction. Remember, much science fiction is a warning of Satan's plans. All of the above will come to pass at a separate time interval in history, all over the world, not just America. I give this prophet writing a warning in a dream about portals of hell opening up and a UFO invasion happening. Take it seriously. Only those crying out in the name of YAHUSHUA HaMashiach will be spared at that time. Seek me while you can yet find me. Shelby Colbert refuses to repent and admit the date she gave, that I, YAHUSHUA, was to return, did not come to pass, because I did not give her that dream, nor interpretation, nor date for my return. This prophet I now speak forth from told you in advance not to believe her. I sent this prophet to warn you, so you would not be dismayed when the time passed. Watch, wait, and work until the true catching away. I have said in Revelations 14, there will be a first fruit rapture of 144,000 first. Now few want to believe this, for it goes against your itchy ears and your flesh. When the year 2007 passes, will you still make excuses for Shelby Corbett and Kenneth Copeland, amongst others? What is the matter with my holy children? Can they not discern the eyes of a serpent in Kenneth Copeland? Those who have sold books stating, and thus saith the Lord, this is the date of the rapture of the church, or they say a prayer and be guaranteed heaven. I ask you, will you refund the money people paid for your book? Holy people, write and ask for a refund of your money. Shelby Corbett, Kenneth Copeland, Chew Thomas, and others, you lead my people to a false rapture. You calculate the day of their deaths, and you slowly kill the faith of the few faithful, silent, frightened, innocent lambs that are in the rapture now, and Five Doves Forum and many other forums. How many of you watch and wait for Jesus to come and speak it loudly, and yet do not even realize, I do not call you the bride of YAHUSHUA HaMashiach? Most of you only know me in part. Am I not the same YAHUSHUA that rebuked the Pharisees and called them snakes and vipers? I have no kind words for the enemies of Yahweh, whose names are not found in the Lamb's Book of Life. Did not Yahweh say, the evil Pharaoh that Moses battled was only born for destruction? Did I not give you an example when I, Yahushua, cursed the fig tree because it produced no fruit for me? Did it not wither and die up and death was proclaimed? And never would it produce fruit again? I tell you a secret. That tree still remains a dead tree as a warning sign of what happens when something or someone is cursed by Yahweh. Do you not read Deuteronomy 28 and Deuteronomy 30? The Holy Scriptures are full of blessings to those who obey Yahweh and curses to those who disobey Yahweh. The Ten Commandments are still valid today. Nothing has changed. I, Yahushua HaMashiach, did not come to cancel the laws that Abba Yahweh wrote with his own finger on the tablets of stone. These commandments stand for all eternity. The fourth commandment is a sign between Yah and those who truly worship Yah. The fourth commandment in the great millennium will still stand, and people shall come and worship on the true Shabbat. Read, study, and show yourself approved. The holy feast days, you will be commanded to come and observe when I rule and reign on earth. That which people shun now, the fourth commandment, is also honored in heaven. What was called sin back in the times of old is still sin today in Yahweh's eyes. Lawmakers, you think because you decree new laws, because of the stench that rises to heaven from your sins, because you change the laws of the land, it changes the laws in heaven. You shall reap hell and the lake of fire for doing this. You cannot erase my name so easily, or that of Yahweh. America and Europe, you embrace the heathen gods now, because you have forsaken your one and true God, Yahweh, and I, Yahushua. Your hearts are full of every evil. Not enough holy people rose up to protest against the abomination that became laws. Now it is a race to see which politician can speak the most abominable lies and pass the most abominable laws. You slander this ring maiden I speak this prophecy through, and yet she is the one I use to be the crier to warn the true bride. As written in the parable of the 10 virgins, again I say, I will send Michael, the archangel, to her along with Gabriel, and they shall speak the day to Elizabeth, and at the precise time the trumpet blows, she cries out, behold, the bridegroom doth come. All the true bride of Yahushua Mashiach, spoken of in Revelation 14, all over the world will hear it at the same time and rise in the air. No one does know the exact time and hour. I have only told her the holy day will be on Rosh Hashanah. Since Rosh Hashanah is 2 days and many people have different calculations which date it falls on, it is true she does not know the hour. However, just as Elijah knew he would be taken, just as Noah knew the day he was to enter the ark and close the door, so it shall be again. My bride will know when they hear in the spirit the crier cry out and say, behold, the bridegroom doth come. You see, Satan wearies and mocks you now. As one after another proclaims they know the day and the hour, and yet again I repeat myself, so none will be deceived. This is why I command you to cover her in prayer, for there is but one I call my ring maiden. Elizabeth Elijah will not know until I send the holy angels to her, like I have before with other holy messages given to her. I did this so she can believe, as I sent my holy angels first to Montana, then Idaho and South Africa. I will do it again. In South Africa, both her and her husband saw Archangel Michael in a place that they least expected it. In a restaurant in Camps Bay, South Africa, Michael had instructions to appear before her. And her husband Nico noticed Elisabeth staring at a man, and he staring back. As soon as Nico saw Michael, he knew this was no ordinary man. It was a heavenly spiritual connection. Abba Yahweh Saint Michael, which is not the proper spelling of his name, but I give you the spelling you recognize. To increase her faith, Archangel Michael was sent to her when Satan tried to take her life for 3 days, and while her husband slept, though she tried to awaken him when the holy angels were there, it was not for his eyes to see yet. The holy angels Michael and Gabriel came and brought healing in their wings as she touched them like a little child and marveled at the beauty of the gems embedded in them. The holy angels proclaimed how excited all of heaven was at the news of the bride of Yahushua would be arriving shortly, and the next time she saw them together, it would mean it was time to call the bride home to heaven. The holy angels also proclaimed the birth of Yahushua's demon stompers and told her to assemble the holy prayer warriors on the wall so she would know she does not take on the enemies of Yahushua alone. Again, this was to increase her faith. And she was immediately healed, and the spirit of death was forced to release from her. Enemies of this ministry, remember this. When you touch this ministry, you touch my holy, sinless, divine blood. And my name is Yahushua HaMashiach. I protect and cover this ministry, along with legions of holy warrior angels. Be warned, all who curse this ministry, the curses shall be reversed back to you. You who have the spirit of religion and not a loving, obedient relationship with Abba Yahweh, you dare to call on the name of Jesus Christ to ask for the destruction of this woman and this holy ministry. Remember this, the prayers you lift up and each word you say, you will be held accountable for. Abba Yahweh and I, Yahushua HaMashiach, will put you in remembrance of your words when you wonder why everything is going wrong in your life. You wonder why your finances, health, and peace is taken. Destruction is all around you and your loved ones are dead. Now you know the reason why. For I have just told you ahead of time when you are left behind to suffer in the great tribulation. To all the people who are reading this and have eaten and enjoyed the fruits of this ministry, yet have never contacted them or have never encouraged this ministry in any way, you will be reminded at this time also. Remember, if one holy person can put 1,000 demons to flight, two can put 10,000 demons to flight, how much more can a million believers do? This ministry will battle for you as you battle for this ministry. I, Yahushua HaMashiach, tell you this. This is the last end time church that preaches the entire truth, including that which King James refused to allow to be written. It will be written. These truths will be preached. And I use my holy people, who the world knows not their names, for they have not been soiled by the filth of the world. These I choose to use for the last end time church. Do not desire fame and will never compromise my truth for fortune. They are not for sale and Satan has no claim on them. The ones used in this last end time church has suffered and do suffer for my sake. How few of you reading this would be willing to pay this price? Most reading this are focused on their own world, their own life and family. They are not out on the front lines of faith doing spiritual warfare. Now is the time for Yahushua's demon stompers to arise and cover this ministry, support and encourage this ministry and profit. Defend this ministry, for you are fed by my hand through this ministry. It is green pastures for my sheep and lambs. Some reading this insists on calling my name,
J-E-S-U-S. Although you know my true Hebrew name, but you say you prefer the Greek name Jesus. Again, I repeat myself. Do not misunderstand me. There is still forgiving, healing, delivering, resurrection power and signs, wonders and miracles done in the name of Jesus Christ at this time in history, because my true Hebrew name was not common knowledge, and because it is before the great tribulation. But you have been warned. Even now, a man uses the name Jesus Christ and proclaims to have a million followers, and yet is a servant of Satan. This evil man goes by the name of Jesus Miranda. Just because he uses the name of Jesus, you must test the spirit of the man. The name of Jesus is counterfeited all over the world, especially in South America. The man who has taken the name Jesus Miranda is a false prophet and an evangelical prosperity pimp that has sold his soul long ago and is totally possessed by Satan. He is evil in every way. He preaches there is no such thing as sin. Hell is a lie. He proclaims to be God and denies most of the Bible. Everyone that has received the mark 666 as a tattoo, because Jesus Miranda told them to show loyalty to him in this way, has already had a foretaste of the curse of the damned. Everyone that calls this man God and believes he is Jesus Christ has already been taken over by Satan and received the curse of the damned. Satan mocks to show how easy it will be in the Great Tribulation to get Christians to compromise and reject what they once knew to be true. Satan shows how easy it is to mock the name Jesus Christ. Can you not see why in the Great Tribulation it will happen again? And no prayers will I, Yahushua HaMashiach, answer in the name and the son of Satan, whom you call the Antichrist, will use? People will pray in the name of Jesus, and just like the one that calls himself Jesus Miranda, the only begotten son of Satan, will be tricking people with false signs, wonders, and miracles, and he will proclaim to be God and say, "Here I am." You are being warned through this prophet I call my ring maiden, and this warning is like a gong ringing around the world. Take these prophecies and warn others. When your pastors refuse to humble themselves and admit they were wrong and receive the truth, you take it, little ones. You share with others and rebuke that pastor in my name. They have only shown you the spirit of religion, puffed up with the spirit of greed, lust of the flesh, and pride rules and reigns all of them. They have not obedient, humble spirit. My Holy Spirit, your Mama Wisdom, who is the Ruach HaKodesh, is not ruling nor reigning in them. They listen to their accountants, and Satan has them focused on material possessions more than a spiritual walk for their own sake. They have lost their first love. All who have stolen my glory have lifted up their own names to draw people nigh, forgetting the Holy Scriptures say, when the name of Yahushua HaMashiach is lifted up, I will draw all men nigh. If a person names a ministry or church after themselves, they are drawing people by their own works and name. It is doomed to fail, and in heaven all their works will be counted as stubble and hay and burnt up. The evangelical prosperity pimps have become famous and stars even in their own eyes, as well as others for Satan's kingdom. They are no longer the men and women who once truly served and worshipped and prayed Yahweh's will to be done. For fame and fortune, they allowed evil spirits to come in and rule and reign through their bodies. In the Great Tribulation, The name of Jesus will again be used by the counterfeit, and it will be by one called the Antichrist, who is the only begotten son of Satan. And this time in history, there are some Sunday churches that still are used for my glory, but in the Great Tribulation, all the Sunday churches will be used for Satan's glory, and the mark of the beast will be in the Sunday churches at that time. You have been warned. Do you not understand the importance of knowing this warning now and learning my Hebrew name now, getting in the habit of using my Hebrew name now that my earthly Hebrew mother gave me when I was born? I always send my true prophets to warn before the judgment. Teach other now these truths so they will not go to Sunday church in the Great Tribulation. Because if you enter the Sunday churches during the Great Tribulation, you will receive the mark of the beast. The final act of rebellion will cost people their souls. I grieve as I see my holy scriptures quoted, as in the times of old. The Pharisees and Sadducees also did this to me, not realizing I am the Word that became flesh. My little ones, I have put a desire in you not to conform into other people's images of religions. Instead, you desire to be holy. You desire to be pleasing unto Abba Yahweh. And when you do sin, you hear Mama Ruach HaKodesh's soft voice lovingly rebuking and convicting you to return to holiness. You are shown the error of your ways, and you quickly repent and turn away from your sin, and come running back into Abba Yahweh and I, Yahushua's loving arms. Do you think I enjoy chastising you when you go off on a path of sin? Yet times my children are as a disobedient child in willful rebellion that must be disciplined. Some of my children need more discipline than others. Yet I say, at times, even a spanking done out of love is administered by the mother or father of the child. It is necessary as a reminder that there are consequences for sinful behavior. This is true also with Abba Yahweh and I, Yahushua.
Which child are you?
Some of our children only need a gentle scolding and a reminder of why didn't you obey me. Others need a loud scolding. Still others who are so hard-headed need a spanking from Yahweh for the sake of the salvation of their soul. This is done so the willful one, full of rebellion, will repent and realize it is either Yahweh's way or it will be hell's highway. If you insist on continuing in sinful behavior, at times this good shepherd must break my little lamb and sheep's leg to keep you from getting too close to the edge of the fires of hell, where Satan can claim your soul. If I do not stop you from wandering into the den of Satan, where wolves wait to devour your flesh and spirit, who will stop you? I am the only good shepherd, and I, Yahushua, do not lose one of my sheep or lambs. I already know all the names written in my book of life before the foundation of this world. Remember, I do not tolerate the behavior of a spoiled brat, demanding it be done your way and not Yahweh's will or way. You who have done this have already reaped the consequences brought on by sin. Some of you reading this now have suffered through divorce, child custody battles, unhappy marriages, drug addictions, alcohol addictions, other addictions, jail, sexual diseases, children born out of wedlock, nervous breakdowns, suicidal attempts and thoughts of suicide, depression, mental illness, confusion, idolatry, fornication, homosexuality, pornography, lust, robbery, stealing, murder, abortion, unemployment, and poverty. This list is but a small example of what the spirit of rebellion against Yahweh's will brings. All of you reading this now know what my love, grace, mercy, and forgiveness has delivered you from. Only after you repented to Yahweh
In I, Yahushua HaMashiach's name, am turned away from the sin of rebellion. When you are scorned and persecuted for my name's sake, you just know that great is your blessings in heaven. It is not you they attack, beloved little one. It is I they attack. For when the heathen and the spawn of Satan rages against you, they do not see your face when they attack. They see the face of holiness, and they see the sweet Holy Spirit within you. You must be a water walker in your faith. Keep on the path of holiness, for narrow is the path to heaven, and broad is the path to hell. Even if no one else around you follows the path I have laid before you, do not turn back, little one. I am not going to promise the path will be easy, but it will be worth it. The path to heaven is full of sacrifices, but remember, I, Yahushua HaMashiach, gave the greatest sacrifice of all. The plans I have for you, my treasures, is for good and not for evil. When you are lonely, turn to your Abba Yahweh, and I, your only deliverer and Mashiach. Remember, the sweet Holy Spirit within you is your Mama Ruach HaKodesh, and she is closer to you than your next breath. When you cry, allow her to rock you in the cradle of her arms, giving you a peace that surpasses all understanding. Remember, your body is the temple of the Ruach HaKodesh, so whatever happens to your body happens to her also. Stay in truth and holiness, and never allow Satan to defile you. For I have given you an anointing and gifts you know not, but in due time it will be revealed. Continue to seek my footsteps each day, for the footsteps of the holy are ordained by I, Yahushua, and by your Abba Yahweh. Your name, beloved one, is engraved on the palm of my hands done at Calvary. I suffered in your place, so you would be saved and have access to Yahweh and heaven once again. I love you, little one, with a love that no man or woman can compare with. I have stored up all of your holy tears, each vial of tears that you have shed for my name's sake. I give you a warning, though for the times ahead. Do not depend on any church denomination or religion to save you or to keep you holy. Be holy not to please others, but to please Yahweh. You must remember our relationship is not about a religion. It is about worship, love, and obedience without compromise, and living holy unto Abba Yahweh and I, Yahushua HaMashiach. Keep your body holy and undefiled for our praise, honor, and glory. Keep your thoughts stayed on me. Keep your eyes focused on me. Some reading this are teenagers, and yet you are wiser than others your age. You are even wiser than many of the adults that surround you. But allow not your head to become full of pride, for that will ruin the good plans I have laid for you. Seek my face and continue to grow in my grace and anointing each day. You do not reject this prophet. You hear my voice even when it goes against what others say. And you will not compromise nor back down. Do not do anything that I, Yahushua, would not do. I know every rejection, every pain, every worry, every lie of the devil that has been spoken in your ear, every temptation and thought. My shed blood at Calvary, you are victorious. Remember this, dearest little one. If all the people had received my truths, then all the people would receive the truths you share. Because they deny me, they will deny you. Because they persecuted me, you will be persecuted for my name's sake. Homosexuality is an abomination. Abortion is murder. Do not allow your mind to conform to what the laws of your land deem lawful. Rather read the Bible and see what my word decrees as sin. Evolution is a lie of Satan. You know all of these things. Stay far away from any sexual sin, and stay away from any drug or liquid that intoxicates and twists, controls, and perverts your mind. Stay far away from anyone who worships another, whom they call God, and yet you know it is a false God. Do not even listen to their false doctrines, or it opens the door to lying and deceiving spirits to enter into your mind.
Plead the blood of our YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, and stay away from anyone in the occult, or reads occult books such as Harry Potter, or uses the occult in any form.
Do not allow the demons in other men and women, boy or girl, to possess your body, even through a kiss. Be not unequally yoked in any way. Satan will use the lusts of your flesh to tempt you, but I, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach's shed blood and name, has overcome temptation, if you will but use it. Let the heathen mock and laugh. YAHUVEH will have the last laugh. Understand that the heathen teenagers can be the cruelest of all people. Those that do persecute you will one day rue the day they ever laughed, cursed, or mocked you. In hell they will be forced to remember each word they spoken against you, and they will hear these words for all eternity if they do not repent and accept I, YAHUSHUA, as their Mashiach. Lead souls to the only door of salvation. I am YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, and I am the only door. I am the only way and the truth to enter heaven and stand before Abba YAHUVEH. Do not lead anyone to a church for salvation, for church can't save a soul. Salvation comes through the repenting of sin and acknowledging that I, YAHUSHUA, am the only begotten Son of YAHUVEH and the Lord God Almighty. Worship YAHUVEH and I and our beloved precious Ruach HaKodesh, who is Mama Wisdom, with a loving, obedient, repentant relationship to I, YAHUSHUA. When you sin, be quick to repent and turn away from evil. Do not premeditate sin and think, oh well, I will repent later. It does not work that way. If you depend on a church for your relationship with YAHUVEH and I, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, what will you do when the church preaches a false doctrine? The pastor compromises such as those I have named above. I can hear some of you say, oh well, my church is a good church. I have a holy pastor. I say to you, even if it is a church with good fruit, what will you do when you cannot rely on a church, a pastor or a person for spiritual support because the doors have been closed or outlawed by your country, or your pastor has been put in jail for preaching the gospel or moved and you have no access to that person or prophet? This is why I want you to talk to me. Let us fellowship together. Share your interests with me. I desire not only to be your Lord and Savior, your God, but also your best friend. Salvation is one-on-one with YAHUVEH and I, YAHUSHUA, and my people are filled with our precious Ruach HaKodesh. My word says, forsake not the assembly of yourselves together, but that does not mean it must always be in a church building. Even now you are assembled yourselves together through the technology of a computer, communicating with one another. There is coming a day very soon when you will have to pray and discern, should you witness to this person or will it be a trap of the government? Any nation that loses their religious freedom is because they allowed the government to strip them away little by little until all that is left is a dictatorship and the work of the Antichrist. America and Europe, how far you have fallen from our grace and mercy. Churches in America, the shame is upon you for selling yourselves in fear of losing your tax-exempt status. The majority of churches in the world will no longer allow my true apostles and prophets to prophesy, rebuke, exhort, encourage, and mentor. Pastors, have you forgotten there is but one good shepherd, and it is I, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach? You pastors in the majority of the churches do not want any fresh manna or new wine from the precious Ruach HaKodesh. You do not want to change your man-made doctrines or thinking. The majority of the churches have pastors that run the churches like a dictatorship. This offends me greatly. As the largest, to the smallest church congregations did not march to protest to their governments, speaking loudly so all can hear. Instead, they have remained silent as laws that Yah has decreed as an abomination are passed as legal in the lands and even taught as truth in the schools. Woe be unto any nation or school that removes biblical truths and governments that no longer revere the words, "In God we trust." My little ones, teach the people the truths. No churches can save any soul. Only through my shed blood at Calvary and my name can anyone be saved. Through repentance and turning away from all evil, teach them to keep Yahweh's commandments and to put Yah first in their life and love, and to bring their everyday questions to Yah so they can trust Yah for their large questions. Remember, your works will be rewarded in heaven, and the only rewards you receive on earth is what you do for me. Teach the babies you lead to me to pray and use my sacred Hebrew name, Yahushua HaMashiach. Warn them they must not compromise. Teach the people the true Shabbat and the importance of observing the holy feasts. Continue to teach of heaven and hell, for more souls will go to hell than to heaven. Learn of me, and I shall use you to teach and lead others to me. Out of the mouth of babes do I speak. Remain pure of heart, body, and soul, and I will give you a love with the same heart after I, Yahushua HaMashiach. If you desire your soulmate, their body will be pure before me, with a desire to worship and serve me above all else as you do. Your soulmate shall be full of holiness, and together you shall lead souls to the kingdom of heaven. You are not to wonder who this person is. I will bring your soulmate when I know both are ready. Take daily communion with me and speak to me with words of love and gratitude for the price I paid for you at Calvary. Make sure before you take communion, you confess and you are determined to turn away from any sin in your life. If you have wronged another brother or sister who is a devout believer in me, confess the sin to me and ask my forgiveness. Then go to them and ask their forgiveness. Do not take communion and practice sinning at the same time. I would have gone to Calvary and suffered and died and rose again on the third day, even if it was only for one person. I love you that much. I make a vow to Abba Yahweh. I would not lose one soul whose name has already been written in the Lamb's Book of Life before the foundation of the world. Never should the words spoken during communion be of mere repetition, and do this not only in remembrance of the price I, Yahushua, paid at Calvary for you, but praise me that I shall not drink of the fruit of the vine again until I do so with my bride and the guests at the marriage supper in heaven. Remember, this is a weapon against Satan. As you continually remind him, Satan has no claim on your mind, body, spirit, or soul, unless you, through sin, give him the legal right. Be ye holy as I am holy. Strive to live holy in your mind and body, and walk in the Holy Spirit more than you walk in the flesh, and know that legions of heaven's holy angels fight in your behalf.